So I go over testing. So one of the key things that I talk about a lot is when you're studying for the exam, you've got to really stick with the book. You can know certain things. You can know, like, they use, like, so for example, Carrie asked about the clock method. When it comes to the clock method, they talk about the clock, like the labrum, like a clock, right? So here's your glenoid, and then here's your labrum, right? So at the very top is where you'll have a slap lesion, and then at the bankart, at the on the anterior side, you'll have a different type of labrum tear depending on where it is. But they call it like 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 9 o'clock. So they talk about it like the clock method. I don't know if there's another part in the chapters that they might talk about the clock method, but in the very first parts of the chapter, they talk about the globe. It's the same shit. Clock, globe. They're both round. They're both round. North, south, east, west. So, you gotta look at these, the similarities about it. So this is, superior, this is inferior, this is anterior, this is posterior. So when you look at it, it's kind of like, it's still all the same thing. They're just talking about the glenoid as being round, and the different positions. So in that sense, it's easy to remember, right? Because they're all round and everything is about positions. And I kind of talk about a little bit of the kinesiology stuff because I had to restudy that once I started teaching kinesiology. I was like, dear Lord, how do I remember this? I haven't studied this. I haven't looked at this in years. But every time you take those classes, they always talk in those planes. And then because you don't do it a lot, you have to your brain is translating the, okay, hold on, sagittal, okay, I'm trying to remember, was it, which way was it? Like, how do I divide my body? Right? Yeah, same thing when I first started taking classes. I mean, I would sit there and I'm like, I think I need to translate this shit when I get home because I just didn't know what they were talking about half the time. But if you kind of listen to that portion of it, I just slowly, go over a little bit just to remind you, because that's all it is. When they talk about it in the book, your brain, when you're reading it, your brain almost is slowing down a little bit and be like, okay, well, hold on. Are they talking about flexion and extension? But they kind of trick you. And they're not doing it on purpose, but each person writes a chapter, right? It's not like the same, in my book, I wrote 10 chapters. I wrote all 10 chapters, so my language and how I write it is the same. In these books, different people are writing different chapters, and so you'll see some people using the words like anterior and inferior a lot more, and then some people are using like medial, lateral, versus other words, it's so obnoxious. But that's part of the translating. But I think once you kind of understand it a little bit easier, it makes the flow of understanding better.